All right, this video is going to cover five different reasons why you may want to use calculated fields in your pivot table. And these calculated fields will greatly expand what you can do with an old-fashioned pivot table. And you'll see the possibilities as we go through these. So the source data that we're going to use is these five columns, right? And we'll go over here. We'll say insert pivot table. So we'll just start with good old-fashioned pivot table. We'll select the data. Click OK. We'll put it on the existing sheet and we'll just put it in cell G2 up at the top. Okay, so I click create empty pivot table. Let's build it out with standard functions. It'll just take a second. We're interested in the materials, so that's what we want to analyze. We'll put that in the rows and then we'll put the amount as one of the values. And it defaults to sum. Sum works for this, right? So it's just adding up the amount of sales, we'll say the number of units. And then we'll take price and we want to add that as another column of values. So we will add that to the values field. And let's say we want average price. So that's still available. You don't have to do a calculated field yet. Let's just select average. And this is the average price for each unit. Okay, so now that we have these two, we'll call them typical boring rows, right? We're going to find a reason why we might want to use a calculated field. So let's say we want to find the total amount of sales in dollars for each of these items. We don't want to go add it to the source data over here on the left. We want it in the pivot table because we want to leave the source data just as it is. So what we want to do, because you can't combine two different fields into one in the standard menu here that we have to the right in the pivot table editor, we'll do a calculated field. So we will come over to the values and we're going to click on add. Let me stretch this out a little bit. Okay, we'll click on add and we will see these are the fields that are already there. These are the column headers over to the left, but we want a calculated field. So we'll click that. We want to take the amount, the sum of the amount, multiplied by the average of the price. And whenever you do these, the summarize by, it defaults to sum. I'll just take that off, just make it custom. You don't want it adding a sum into your formulas when you don't want it adding a sum. Just take that off and if you want it, add it yourself. So I'm actually going to do that. So here, the first thing that we want to multiply is the sum. And then now we're going to use column headers, not cell references. So we'll say, I'll get back in that field, amount. And then we will multiply that by the average of the price. Give it a second, it should refresh here. There we go. So that's a calculated field using two different functions in two different fields. So you can also update this field. So instead of calculated field one, we'll say total price. All right, that's the first reason why you'd want to use a calculated field. Let's go down to the second one. Let's say that you want to use a function that's just not available in this list. So we'll look at these dropdowns. There's a lot of functions here. Frankly, you'll usually find what you want. Now let's just say that we want to use the count blank function. So we want to see how many rows are missing their data. So we will take, let's just leave this calculated field. We'll change the header on it. We'll say missing data. And we'll come down, we'll change the calculated field. We're going to say count blank. And you just put in the column header of the column you're concerned about being blank, right? So we'll say we're worried about where it's missing a price. Let's give this a second to update. And well, it looks like all the prices are there, right? But if you go through, let's just delete one. And this will be for brass. You see brass now shows that one piece of data is missing. So that's an example of how to use a not as common, so we'll say rare function in a pivot table. In the next situation where you want to use a calculated field is a conditional function. So let's say you want to count these if the unit price is greater than 20. Let's go here and update our header. We'll say greater than $20. And we will change the formula to count if. Let me look at my website that I wrote here. I'll put a link to this in the description. It's the same stuff. Price, so that's the column that we're checking. And we'll just say greater than 20. So the countif function uses a weird syntax, frankly. So you have to put in those quotes around the greater than and the 20, even though it's a number. That's how you get it to work. And we see that we sold aluminum 70 times when it was over $20. Let's test that. Let's find aluminum. And we're going to change this one to be under $20. Right now it says 70. If I change it to $12, it should update. Wah, wah. Oh, that's cost. Price, 12 bucks to 69. All right, so that's working. Let's look at the next reason is just that it's cleaner and more reliable. So the alternative would be adding new columns into your source data or adding columns, heaven forbid, to the right of the pivot table and referencing the data. All of those can shift and move. And if you add new data, you can forget to add those new columns. But if you add them as calculated fields, they'll always be there. And then in tandem with that is the increased reliability. So let's say that you have this source data and it's coming from an automated solution. So maybe every time you have a sale, it's added to the bottom. Well, if you are adding columns to the source data and you forget to add them, you might not know and it'll come into your pivot table wrong, but a calculated field will pick that up. All right, so this next video is going to show you how to use an add-on that will combine multiple pieces of source data on different worksheets into one pivot table. So I'll see you in that video. Thanks for watching.